Well, I'm kind of behind the curve on this, but I'm not too late. This is one of the new guns in BO3, and that is the HLX-4. Please don't kill me. I saw you. Also saw you. This gun absolutely freaked me out when I first used it, because I was so confused with how the weapon would fire that I just didn't understand it. And essentially, is he over on our, oh, okay. I missed every shot. Guess the dude with the ridiculously overpowered pistols is gonna get the kill. Anyways, when I first fired this gun, it stopped shooting when I let go of the trigger, and I had to do this weird cockback thing, and I was trying to burst it. So that's all it was doing over and over and over, and I was freaking out because I didn't know what was going on. I'm like, this gun's not working, guys. It keeps reloading. I basically almost died because I couldn't shoot the gun. I don't know. It's so weird, but it is very good. It's actually probably one of the best SMGs to challenge the VMP, along with the Vesper, I would say, obviously, but this is not a bad one in any way. Oh, he run away, really? Whatever. I got the corner, so I'm holding it now. And right now I'm using fast mags. Wow, the team is destroying. Holy shit. Fast mags, long barrel, and grip on it. Because it does have a really high rate of fire, and because you can't burst this weapon to go longer distances like you could with a VMP, I decided you're probably better off to try to keep it relatively steady when you're firing. So that's the class I have right now. I haven't used it a ridiculously large amount. I used it quite a bit last night on stream when I got it, because you guys voted to watch BO3 yesterday on stream. So I said, okay, I might as well try going for these new weapons. And I got both. And I'd like the LV8 Basilisk, but I think I like this one a bit more. This gun seems to absolutely wreck kids' life. And it also, because it's an SMG, is more fun for me to play with. Because I am an aggressive player. Oh, like I got, oh, he got murdered again by the pistols. That's all the guy uses. 5-0 using the Marshals. This is probably up there with the Marshals in terms of pay to win. Honestly, it really is. I'm not a big fan of the supply drop system. I'm not a big fan of the pay to win model. And it's not even pay to win usually in this game. It's like pay to have fun. Most of the guns aren't very good. They're just funny. The only two guns I would say now at this exception is the Marshal. The crossbows, not the crossbows. Is it a crossbow? Yeah. The crossbows I put up there, they're almost that good. They're very difficult to use though, unless you just spam two of them really close range. Oh, don't let go of the trigger. See, that's the thing, you gotta like remind yourself. But the Marshals and this gun are probably the two best DLC based guns. I gotta do that really quick, otherwise he's gonna run and challenge me. Oh my lord, I am the luckiest player in the universe. Let's go for the dude guys camping in the back. Don't camp, please. It's really boring. Ruins the game. This gun is pretty damn good though. The fire rate is so fast. Like I said, basically Vesper rate of fire, that it has a sick kill time because the damage isn't super weak. Most of the SMGs in this game honestly have about the same damage. That's why the fire rate is so important. The Vesper being the only one that's kind of lower than the rest, but the VMP, the Weevil, I'm pretty sure I'll have about the same damage. The real difference between them is the damage range, how much of that damage is held on at a distance. This gun does have a decent damage drop-off, but you can't really shoot at a distance anyway because of how the weapon works. Like, that cockback that it has screws your long-range gunfights. So you don't even try. You just completely just go for the close-range crap. Don't try the long-range. I use grip to steady it out, but you know, maybe it's not even the best option. I've been tinkering with it and playing with it and seeing where it goes. But, you know, it's a cool gun. It's a cool gun. I'll give him that. That being said, still don't want to see new weapons in Modern Warfare Remastered. I don't care. I don't want it to happen. They can add all the cosmetic changes they want to the game to make it look different. But the point that you add new weapons to the game, you're changing the game. If you're going to change Modern Warfare Remastered, there are many better ways you could do it. You could, you know, remove 3x frags or make frags weaker, or you could nerf the M16 a bit. You know, if you're going to change what Modern Warfare Remastered or what COD 4 was, if you're going to change it, you might as well change it for the better. Adding in new weapons that are also maybe overpowered, maybe not, but adding in new weapons doesn't change that game for the better. It's just, it doesn't. Not in my mind anyway. So if they do that, I really hope they don't, but if they do that, they're going to have to reconsider what they're doing with the changes that they're considering. They're going to have to change a lot, in my opinion. That's how I look at it. So I really don't want to see it. I don't know if I'll continue playing it after they do it. And if all they do is add in new weapons and don't actually change the game for the better and don't, like, you know, possibly nerf or remove some of the most overpowered stuff in the game that we all use, I'm sure. At some point, we all use Doom 16 or all use 3x frags. Some of us more than others because, you know, S&D, a lot of 3x frags users. Some M16s, I'm not a huge fan of it. I just don't like it. But, you know, it's overpowered. We can all admit that. Even though we're using it, we can admit that it's OP as shit. I know. So I'm glad there is no sound horn perk in that game, because good lord, you see how much camping there is now? Could you imagine if people could sound horn you the entire time while they sit still? That's a problem. That's one thing I wish they would fix in this game and a lot of the other Call of Duties they make nowadays. They add in the sound horn perks and makes it shittier. All right, let's go again. I have the Basilisk here. I have my sound horn perks on as well. I did try without it for a while, but I kept getting sound horn back, so I gave up on that. I did my best though with what I had, and then I was like, yeah, fuck this, I'm going back to awareness. I can't compete with these guys that are camping and using awareness on me. All right, they just jumped up actually. I think I'll get the kill. All right, let's reload really fast. There's a guy in the back. Absolutely destroyed him though. And there's his teammate also in the back. Who knows why they're back here, but they are. Any more back here? If there was two, let's assume there's more. There's two guys left. That was just bad freaking. He wasn't even too far back in his spawn. He was kind of on the corner over there. But that wasn't even the problem. The real problem was the KN-44 is a 3-shot at that range, and I missed one of my shots because it went to the left. So if I wouldn't have missed, I probably would have had him. Either way, whatever. New round. Let's start it up. This game, though, I still think was a good game. I just really wish they would have fixed the problems that were, like, not even, like, you know, balancing problems. It was just overall problems, you know? The overall problems with the game are what made it shitty. That's, like, you know, the team balancing wasn't very hot. And then add on the fact, they got a player with that gun too. Add on the fact that people very often disconnected from the party they were playing with. I dare you to challenge it. That was a mistake. Those things are things that I wish they could have fixed. And if they would have, dude, it would have been so much better. So much better, yeah? I don't know how many games. I played a lot of games. I have 25 days played in this game. And I think, on average, every night I played for about 3 or 4 hours on stream. And we disconnected the party at least once an hour. So, I mean, just do the math for 360 days. Let's say 350 days. Maybe I missed 15 or 20 days of streaming. 350 days of the year, 3 hours a night. Let's, you know, 3 times a day, essentially. That means our party got disconnected like over 1,000 times during the course of this game, which is redonkulous. Oh, don't rape me. He's got a rifle. He's got the new rifle. It's not a rifle. This SMG is not a long distance weapon. I shouldn't have done that. I said it wasn't. I knew it wasn't. I knew it had recoil despite using grip. I challenged the guy. Fucking mistake. This is not a rifle. It feels kind of like it is because it has very low recoil. Well, at least for that kind of fire, it has low recoil. I just shouldn't have challenged him. That was my fault. All right, another round. We got this. We're not out yet. We're still leading 2-0. I am looking forward to the next Call of Duty, though. I think they finally have realized that this type of movement, this type of futuristic stuff is not what the people want. I mean, like I said, I don't disagree with it. I don't hate it. It's just, you know, we've done it a lot. Might as well try something new. Well, I almost killed myself. Great flash, Nick. Great flash. So I'm looking forward to the next COD. I want to see what they do. Oh my lord, the shotgun brecky! Fucking nerd gun, dude. Oh! Yeah, you know, just camp and wait down there with one of the dumbest guns in the game. Casually. What a great player. I look forward to it because I know it's going to be, at least I really feel like it's going to be an older game. Playing the games for quite a long time now, you just get feelings of things, and I feel like they're finally going to. You just, teammate, really? Oh, man. I feel like it's going to be an older game. And with that, I think they're going to do something similar to, I would put like a time frame between Modern Warfare and like World at War. I would love to see that. I'd be really honest to see. I'd be happy to see even older games. Like I can't talk at all, but like Civil War and stuff. That'd be sweet. I doubt it would happen, but it would be sweet. Get off my wall, ho! That's my wall. Holy shit, where's our whole team? It was a free win. Where'd they all... whatever. People don't like winning nowadays, you know? Winning games, getting carried, just leave the game. Sure, man, sure. Let's see if we can get the W still, though. That's the goal. I'm afraid to boost now that I'm kind of loud. Just gonna move around like I'm a sneaky little beaver. On the left, maybe? Terrifies me every time that I do that. There's almost no one ever there, but it terrifies me every time. I don't know if he just broke the glass there or not. Yep, he did. Okay. Go up top. Sneaking around still. Not in the corner. Do you go back to our spawn? We can control B from here if we want to. Dude, this guy is going off. Life Crusher. G fucking G, bro. Keep it up. I mean, you are using the sweaty VMP, but still. I don't blame you when it's a 2v6. Oh, the Brecky dude is last left, dude. What a bitch. Okay. Got a sound whore now. Be very sneaky. I hear him there. Did he see me? Oh my god, the fucking- you can't burst this gun! I keep forgetting- I'm so used to SMGs that don't have that weird cockback. So when I let go of the trigger, it does this stupid ch-ch. I have to full auto it. Otherwise, he can get away really easily. Same with the other gun, the rifle, if you haven't used that one yet, but... god damn, that is so... just strange. It's not like any other SMG I've ever used, so I'm totally not used to it at all. That's right, came out of the darkness, just stabbed him in the back. Got the W again. GG, Life Crusher going in. LeBron didn't do too bad though, 3-3. He made a dumb play, but 3-3 is still better than average for the most people we get on our team when we're playing solo, at least in my mind. Hope you guys enjoyed though. I hope you like the new weapon. If you have it, you're still playing BO3, possibly. If not, it's all good. I just decided, you know, since I played this game the other day, it wasn't too bad. I'll show you the new weapon. I might as well. Back to MWR tomorrow, and if you are still watching this video, I will let you know right now, it is your last day to enter the giveaway that we're doing. Use the top link in the description to enter, and I'll be picking people to win some free games tomorrow. Thank you for all the support this year. I hope you have a great New Year's, and I will see you all later. Goodbye.